I never lived the dream of the prom kings and the drama queens. I'd like to think the best of me is still hiding up my sleeve. They love to tell you.
Now, if you know that song, in fact, you know the video, you'll be very pleased and excited to see that sitting next to me in the studio is John Mayer. Welcome to Space.
Thank you.
Hey, that's all right. Now, you're pleased that you were saying before, oh, shit, I feel too corporate. You want to give a more relaxed impression?
Well, no, I just realized that I was looking at that video, and I'm the only guy on a video network with a dress shirt on.
You're trying to give that impression. Are you that kind of guy?
No, I just thought it would be kind of cool. I don't know, it just made sense to me for the moment.
That's all right. You're allowed to do that.
Very jQuery.
I'm intrigued. How does a 24-year-old American guy get to be here right now in New Zealand? The process of there to here. Tell me the story.
I don't know. I mean, it's so gradual, and it happens in such an interesting arc that I just know that I've kind of lived every day for just the day. And at the end of the day, someone tells me, hey, tomorrow's going to be cooler.
Oh, look, come on. That all sounds a little bit too philosophical.
Someone must have given
you a break. Were you busking on a street corner and someone said,
okay,
I like that
guy's face? You're asking, like, what is the one kind of defining moment?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think the defining moment was probably making a demo CD.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was, to me, for all the work that I could possibly do and play one place every night, a CD was like my being in certain people's cars all the time, you know? Because I played my ass off before I had a CD out.
You really?
Yeah.
Did you get it back?
No. No, you see this? Look at it.
What's
up?
You could do with a bit of work there, mate.
Like, it's like a load.
But the thing is, you know, some girls, I think, would dispute the fact, because you have got lots of female fans looking on the internet. There are girls that are, you know, they're saying you are their future husband. How does that affect you?
I kind of like the depth of, like, someone thinking that I could be their husband. That entails, like, I'm responsible. You know, boy toy, that's, I don't have to be anywhere but just there.
Husband,
you know?
Though, that's definitely something, isn't it?
That involves commitment and responsibility. I can look up to that.
Are you that kind of guy?
Absolutely. I want to lock in.
Are you married?
No, I'm not married.
What are you looking for in a woman?
Certain warmth, number one, a certain kind of warmth that you just want to sit around.
I'm warm.
Yeah, no, you are warm. You're radiating. And also, like, a certain kind of logic, like just kind of logical but still artistic, you know?
Yes. I'm just trying to think of something logical and artistic to say.
No, but just not weepy and over-passionate. Like, passionate when it's supposed to be passionate, and then, like, okay, I gotta go. You're right, you gotta go.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
I'm feeling you. I'm feeling it.
Yeah.
Your music, do you think that most people relate to heartbreak and upset more than they would do happy songs?
I think people have kind of an appetite for having a heavy heart.
Yeah.
You know? I know that even when I'm fine, I still like to put something in every once in a while that makes me feel like, oh.
Yeah?
You know?
When was the last time you cried?
Last time I cried? I don't know. I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, John.
It's just,
I'm like, sorry.
We just met. And
okay,
I can't
true,
tell
true.
You that stuff. I'm still supposed to be Mr. Perfect for you.
That's right. But if you feel like crying, you know, I don't want you to hold it back. You
okay.
Know, it's live television and everything, but, you know, it would be a great moment, and people in New Zealand would remember you forever, so...
That's true.
Do you want to cry?
I can't do it.
Okay, that's
I can
all right.
pee.
I think I'm probably crying, I think, is probably a lot better. Well, what I'd like you to do now is jump up, show the camera your bum, because I think everybody wants to see that, and then get over there.
Okay, check this out again. Look, nothing. I can keep change just back there. I can keep animals back there. And I'm good on my plan.
Will you just get over there and I'll introduce you.
Gotcha.
And then I'll give you the wink.
Gotcha.
And then you know.
Okay. And I'm
Ladies
doing Dark Side
gentlemen.
Of the Moon.
Then what?
I'm doing Dark Side of the Moon.
No, you're going to do the other one. No such thing. You know, it's your hit single?
Yes, that's
it. Yeah, that's the one. He's come all the way from the United States of America. He's got an album out called Room for Squares, which is square, not nerd, square. His name is John Mayer. This is him behind me, and this is his song, No Such Thing.
I'd like to think the best of me is still hiding up my
John Mayer, ladies and gentlemen, yes! Now, Tom Waits is back. It's been 3 years since his last album.
I'm just going to go to the bathroom.
Okay, off you go. It's been 3 years since his last album, which incidentally was his best-selling.